Hello everyone, Onyx here, and this is more Smite. And always, leave a like and a subscribe button if you want to see more of this content. And a comment if you have any ideas what I want or you want me to play. So, no further ado, I'm gonna play more Smite. This is my build on Vulcan, why I do things really. Some games that I don't need to have to use my starter item, I just go back, go first to the boots. But I start with a vampiric shroud because 20 magical, 100 health, 5 MP5, and the passive is killing an enemy restores 10 health and 10 mana. That's good in an early game. But when I don't need to, I just go directly to the chosen focus, because 40 magical power, 250 mana, 10% cooldown reduction, and 80% movement speed. That's the starter, okay? Then, exactly I do that, I need to use or buy the spirit of mages, because 50 magical power, 50 magical penetration, so my turret can gain some kind of penetration, and when I'm juggling, the passive goes into work, your abilities reduce your target's magical protection by 10 for 5 seconds, max 3 stacks, that's 34, that reduce your target's magical protection, because I do most magical, you know, that, okay? And that's, I only have only this one, when I notice that I'm against people who are using a lot of protection, magical protection. Because when you are on the edge to just go exactly take away the 100 protections with, for example, 100 protection, and then you do damage, then it becomes true damage. It's damage that's are so powerful or so damaging it hurts really. However, after that, I need some kind of sustain and survivability, so I go to work sash. I don't use the Book of Tooth because I really don't need that kind of mana, because my passive, if I show you the passive, is whenever a Vulcan successfully hits an enemy, guard one ability, he gains bonus to movement speed and MP5 for 5 seconds. That means when I just my turret hits one guard every time, it gains or gives me movement speed and MP5. Now we go back to the guard builder. With this I have health and power. And the mana it just a plus exactly, okay? So it gives me survivability. And now it comes to the Chronos pendant. This just gives me a more close reduction so I can do more juggling, do much backdraft. Backdraft? No, not backdraft. Backfire. Sorry about that. So I can, you know, juggle with this, this, and this. So usually I just put on first this tower to start shooting. Then I just switch over to the magma bomb to knock them up, and then a quick little motherfucker. I just do a backfire so they can do more damage and mock the enemy and do more damage. And this one, I only use this when I want to scare people off, kill gods, and have a presence, and you know, quite a big presence, because you can shoot very far with this Earthshaker. It's like a nuke, really. Big fucking nuke. However, time to go back to Chronos Pendant. More magical power, 25 MP5, and that goes to, let's see here, are you ready? If I start just to use my passive, I have 40 MP5 ticking every time the girls get shot. And now, I have no way to have a good sustain, really, more tick health back. I have the Gorgon's Peace. The only time, no, sorry about that, I always use this piece because the aura also affects you. You hear me right, the aura affects you. So instead of only 60 magical power, 50% magical lifesteal, and 10% cooldown reduction, you also gain 30 magical power. So it gains 90 magical power and 50 magical lifesteal to all allies within the units. That also includes you. So you gain 30 magical lifesteal. But after the patch, the Pythagorean's Peace are going to get nerfed. So the if you saw the patch video, the Pythagorean's Peace is going to get tweaked, so it will not go that way. But right now, I'm just abusing it. Okay. And here comes the interesting place. Okay. If I'm noticing that Guardian, for whatever reason, don't put any protection at all, I just switch out the Spirit Mages from 20 magic penetration, and I lose 30 magic reduction to 20 magic penetration flat, but I almost doubles or even triples, almost triples the magical power. And here comes the kicker. It also gave me 5 more magic penetration, because it just divided by this number with this number, and you gain, you know, it's a math problem. But here comes the kicker. If you kill an enemy god, all of your cooldowns are reduced by 8 seconds. This cannot activate more than once to 30 seconds. That means, are you ready? I can backfire a shit ton. For example, if I just use my backfire after hell, even if I didn't, already, if I even didn't put anything in backfire and I use the Spear of Dissolution, it will instantly cool down. And you know the cooldown reduction 40%, it goes down to almost 9, 8, somewhere. So it almost cooldowns. And here, it cooldowns, and here already you can only go from 90 to 54, I guess, plus 8, so it goes down to 62. Let's see here. Math is kind of some kind of hard. 43, 42, 41, 50, 49, 48, 47, 46. So it goes down to 46 instead. And remember, the presence is always there. And it's a quite a nuke. So I really hope... Oh, right. And the Root Hootie just makes me an overpowered motherfucker. Plus my MP5, so it starts ticking like freaking hell. So yeah. That's the tactics, really, how I play Vulcan. And abilities, in every start, I always put one of each so I can juggle, okay? Then I always try to maximize Magma Bomb first, because it does a shit ton of damage. And then I just have one there, you know, I just goes back and forth and back and forth, till I get Earthshaker and I start put it in there. And now you understand the reason, okay? So I always put one like this, and always this, and then this, and this, and this. And here comes the kicker. Which one am I supposed to do next? Lesser cooldown, more power, or more damage? Always to backfire, and magma bomb, herb shaker, inferno, backfire, herb shaker. Inferno, backfire, inferno, herb shaker, backfire, inferno, herb shaker. That's I always do in every single game when I was playing Sol Vulcan. And as always, I didn't have to use save, because sometimes it's best to remember where you put in what. But for you, that will not happen. So yeah. Now you understand why I'm always trying to put in the skills, okay? So we're gonna clear this out. And this is the build in every single game. And here comes the relics. You always, always need purification. You know, every time you get stunned or knocked back, or knocked back is a... I'm gonna go back to that later. Slowed or cursed or whatnot. Purification will fox that, and news will not even tick on you anymore. And that even means before you get knocked up. When I'm playing against a god who knocks up people, I always have the habit to use purification after the knocks me up. And it's so damn annoying, because when he knocks me and I flies up, I guess, I always press purification. You can see me, a blue yellow ball, flows up and flows down, and I, in a sense, wasted my purification, because it always ticks in 2 seconds. A lot can happen in 2 seconds. And they're going to switch that from 160 to 130 after the upgrades and the patch in 4.1. Sanctuary. It works exactly, almost exactly as Beats. Instead of this crowd control and all that shit, this will only makes you immune to damage. For example, when you have little health, and you can see Kukulkan uses his ult, and you can see the dragon, just use Sanctuary. However, he can still knock you up. So the best way to see a person who uses Sanctuary is run to him and try to body block, so the ticks, no, the 2 seconds walks over, and then you kill him. But that also means that his abilities will also tick down in 2 seconds. If you think like this, you have an escape and it's 2 seconds away and you're almost dead, you push Sanctuary, you're immune but you get knocks up, and if you have a chance, you have a chance to use ability and just fly off. Meditation, however. Meditation. I only use this. Yeah, more likely. More or less, really. Meditation in Assault, because you have no way to go back to your spawn pool, so you can not gain more HP or mana. So this one is just a... That's going to switch also. Lovely. And you see I used Curse, right? It was not because they anti-healed, it first is slow. Because the worst thing to be stunned... No, right. It exists 3 things that can kill you. When you're stunned, when you're knocked up, and when you're slowed. I have a knock-up, but I have nothing else really. But however, if I have a curse, it ticks for 5 seconds. Think like this. If I use my Ball of Doom, the Magma Bomb, and then use Cursed, and I have no more money, my team can run to him because he's slowed and secure the kill. And they go into just split the curse into Ankh, Curse of Ankh, and the Emblem of Fear, what the fuck it's called. So I'm just gonna use this again, but only for the movement speed reduction. Okay? So yeah, that's my tactic really. And you cannot say, oh, this is exactly what's going to happen in the game, really. You can't. However, if you know, and, alright, I almost forgot. It exists builds and counter builds. You can see your enemy's build and you can counter to it. I don't use that very often. Why? Because if you only have a build to counter a build, then they have also a build to counter you. Think like that for a moment. If you have a build that only hurts one god, the rest of gods, they counter build you. You follow me? So that's why I have my this build. Because you will never want to you don't want me to juggle combo you, okay? Because I can do a shit of a damage, and I can just do it, push out everything I have. Then you'll get almost 1000 damage, and then it's come to almost 500 damage, and then comes the ticks damage behind me that used to do and support damage, and then I can just fuck you and say fuck off and damage you again and secure the kill. And under that, I have a chance to just run away and gain more MP5 so I can do it all over again. So yeah, that's my build, that's my tactics, and so yeah. I really hope you enjoy watching this, and hello again. And as always, we have some more missions to do. And today's agenda is triple threat, win free games. That will be easy, right? What will possibly go wrong? So, and as always, I will see you again when I have a match. Until then, have a nice waiting for a few seconds. So yeah.
Vulcan.
And I'm gonna play as Vulcan because any reason to play as Vulcan is a good reason. So yeah, what will possibly go wrong? No, nothing really. And as always, I'm gonna edit this out because I don't know when our team and the enemy team finally locks in. So I will see you when it's time to see our team. Bye bye. This is our team. Ratatosker, Vulcan, Hundbats, Fafnir, Kukulkan versus Loki, Kukulkan, Nox, Thor, Bacchus. Anyways, a physical, magical, physical, physical or magical, I forgot what it is, and magical. Physical, magical, magical, physical, magical. Assassin, mage, assassin,
Stop the fire!
assassin, assassin. Yeah, let's see. You're magical also. So good.
My enemies will burn in the fires of my assault!
And as always, if you enjoy watching this, remember to hit that like button and subscribe to see more of this beautiful game. And there it is. And my tactics are you ready? Have a balance between cooldowns and power and mana. Cause that's and yeah. And what I'm always my tactics for using my skills. I always want to level up or max out my magma bomb because he do a lot of damage. And after that, I always want to balance between let's see here, between my tank. My turret and my backfire, and when it's time to you have my ability ready, I always put them out first. Why? Because it does a quite a lot of damage.
Retreat!
And yeah, that's my tactic really. It's probably not a good tactic, but a tactics that always works.
Couldn't
Oh,
have forged it better myself.
and if you want to know, he's going to oh. reached your portal. I always have my spear of the you're dead. Let's see here. What was I trying to say? I always want. Come on. Are you really? Right now I'm just. What the fuck are you guys doing? Wow. sorry about that. I just my mind just left the earth right now, but I just observing what the fuck they was doing. And what the fuck was they doing? I don't know. Like I said, I want to have spare majors because the ability to you to shred the armor, because if they're all going to tank, it's always nice to have that. And when it's time to, you know, I always focus on cooldown ability, because it is always nice to juggle when you're Vulcan. You do a shit ton of damage in a short time notice. So yeah. I will tell you my thought process. My thought process. You are dead. Our mana. Right now we are into the lead. Okay. The reason why I have, you know, this way is because it's easier to find what I want next. It's always good to, you know, have some kind of. Fuck that. Shit. Play nice over there. So yeah. Oh yeah. No, leave them alone. place attack to minions. Retreat, please.
Retreat! My enemies will burn.
If you're noticing, it's quite difficult to have some interesting, you know. Yeah, you know. An interesting sight of things. But one thing's for sure. I have a reason. Well, I just fucked that up. Yep, there goes everything, really. How the fuck did... Oh, when you are a mix between holy shit, what the fuck just happened over there? A mix between an heavy dealer and and disruptor. No, not over.
Retreat!
Not over there, please. Retreat, please.
An ally has been slain.
Oh, thank God we're not fucked up yet. Oh, really? I could have guessed.
Enemy spotted.
Yeah, fuck that. I'll be right back.
Retreat.
My
enemies will burn in the fires of my assault.
Yeah, that's my thought process, really. I just noticed something. When I try to be, you know, informative, I fucked up. What the fuck just happened? I'm not that good, really. Boom, motherfucker. So yeah.
An enemy has been slain.
So yeah. Okay, I'm a hybrid between a high sustain and a hybrid nuke, okay? So it's best to have a cooldown when you're playing Vulcan. His best strategies is to be an high class juggler, you know, trying to combo up shit. And if you do not, and if you do it correctly, you can do a shit ton of damage in a short, quick notice. And if you miss,
kill.
Then you use.
Ultimate is ready. An ally has been slain.
I don't know to speak a good English. Sorry about that. So yeah. Armor strip. Shit. Just retreat.
Retreat!
So right now, what the fuck? We are just tied. That's not good, really.
Couldn't have forged it better myself.
Okay. This is what I'm gonna do right now. I'm gonna sell this to afford this. Because he's not gonna use that much of an I need to use a shred really. So he's going damage. I love that spell and warning, you know, the winning scent. I don't need any cooldowns because I have max cooldown right now. Why? Oh, the Tusker, shut the fuck up. So yeah, I love people when they're fucking yossi. Masturbating the guns. Oh. You don't, retreat! You dumb nut, no you...
An enemy has been slain.
I fucking told you! Oh my god.
Retreat!
Just retreat and defend. Just retreat and defend, okay? Please don't fuck this up now. Don't fuck this up. Oh, come on! Just retreat and defend. Don't go in there yet. I swear to God, if we lose, not because they don't fucking know anything. Attack! Attack! Fucking told you. Jesus, what monkey? Close shave, and a... Oh boy, before I just switch off to the next game, I'm just going to say like this, I thank you for watching, and remember to subscribe, like, favorite, comment, share, and favorite this video. I'm probably gonna do like this. After I do a video on a gameplay, I'm gonna use, you know, I'm bad at trying to get my tactics and talk to you guys and how to do and how to not to do and what to build, not to build, etc., etc. I'm probably gonna say before I do the video, so you can see it in full effect, really. So yeah, I thank you for watching, and I see you in the next one. And remember, I have only 2 more wins. See you soon!